बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास, 10th क्लास कंप्यूटर, चैप्टर नंबर 2, प्रोग्रामिंग इन सी लैंग्वेज। टुडे वी हैव लेक्चर नंबर 12 एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोग्रामिंग बेसिक्स। So let's start our lecture. Today we discuss about topic 2.3 and also we discuss about the C language character set, reserved words and header files. So first of all, programming basic. C language is a very popular and widely used programming language for creating computer programs. Many operating systems and application programs are created by the help of the C language. Let's suppose if we want to develop a game for Android mobile or for any other tablet and computer, so we can use the C language. Today mostly we use the C# language, not the C language and C++ language. But C# language is also a kind of the C language, and C# language is mostly used for the developing of games. But for C# language, first of all, we have to know what is the C language. It means, first of all, we have to understand what is the C language. C language is the basic language for the C++ language and C# language. But in this stage, we only have to know that C language is used in programming the different application programs for games and operating systems. C language character sets. The C language character set includes letters, digits, and special characters. Now, what do you mean by the letters? C language comprises the following set of letters to form a standard program. Okay, which letters? A to Z with the capital letters, A to Z with small letters. Means C language can allow us the lower case and upper case. In C language, small letters and caps letters are distinct. Means if we write the input with the capital letters, means with the uppercase, and if we write the input with the small letters, or we can say that in the lower case, so these both input have the different meaning in the C language. Okay, it means the C language is the case sensitive language. Case sensitive language means both uppercase and lowercase, these both have the different meanings in the C language. Okay, in C language we write the scanf or printf. Scanf for the taking the any value from the user, or printf for printing any data to the screen. But if we write the scanf in uppercase, or if we can write the printf in uppercase, so when we write the scanf or printf in uppercase, it has the another meaning. But if we write the scanf or printf in lowercase, or we can say that in a small letters, so they have the some proper meaning in C language. Okay, so it means in C language, capital letters and small letters have their own meanings, have their different meanings. So we can say that in C language, small letter and upper level, uppercase letters are not the same. They are different in C language. Okay. Now, next is digits. C language use the digits from 0 to 9, because we know that if we have the digit 0 to 9, so we can make any digit with the help of 0 to 9. Okay, as we know that in chapter number 1, we done the some algorithms or we done the some flow charts. We solve their 13 problems with the help of algorithms. And in those 13 flow charts, we use the digits from 0 to 9. Okay, whenever we have to print the odd numbers from 1 to 99, so we use the digits 0 to 9. And we also use these digits 0 to 9 for the condition structure. Okay, for condition structure, we also use these digits as we use for the loop. For loop, we must use the digits. If we don't use the digits, so we cannot write the loop in a C language program. So for the loop, we must use the digits. And normally we use the 1 for initializing the any variable for the loop. So it means digits 0 to 9 are very important in the C language for writing a program or for writing a games. Okay, so if we escape the digits 0 to 9 from the C language, so it means C language is incomplete. Because if we don't have digits 0 to 9, so we cannot write a proper program in the C language. Because we can write a loop with the help of C language and we use the digits 0 to 9. So if we don't use these digits, so we cannot write a program. So digits are necessary for the C language. Now, next is special character. Now, in C language, third thing which is important for the program, that is special characters. C language contains the different types of special characters. And again, special characters have some special meanings in the C language. Okay? So, it means whenever we write the special symbols or special characters from these symbols, so they have the some special or pre-defined functions, or we consider it pre-defined purpose. Okay, so let's suppose percentage sign, dollar sign, least parenthesis, and right parenthesis, plus sign, vertical bar. So these have the special meanings in the C language program. As in the previous chapter, we learned that we have different types of symbols. Let's suppose one symbol is this rectangular symbol. Okay. And we also have the this symbol, diamond symbol. Okay. And we know that these symbols have the special meaning in the C language. Because we know that when we write a flow chart in the chapter number 1 for the different problems, we write the 13 algorithms in unit number 1 and write the 13 flow charts in unit number 1. And in those flow chart, we use these symbols, diamond symbol and rectangular symbols. Now, what do you mean by the diamond symbol? And what is the purpose of the diamond symbol in the flow chart? I hope all of you know very well. Diamond symbols are used for the decision structure. Okay? In diamond symbol, we write the conditions. If marks greater than equal to 80, if marks greater than equal to 70, if marks greater than equal to 60, anything. Okay? So it means this diamond symbol have the specific meaning in the flowchart. Also, this rectangular symbol have the specific meaning in the flowchart. Means rectangle. Whenever we write the rectangular symbol, it means in this symbol we have to write the processing of this program. Okay, as we take the input from the user, Let's suppose enter a number 4 printing a table. So we take the input in that symbol. So same as we know that in flowchart, these two symbols have the some specific meaning and some specific purpose for these two symbols. So same in C language program, when we're writing a different type of programs in the C language, so these symbols have the special meaning. Okay, these symbols have some special meaning in the C language program. Let's suppose if we use this percentage sign, so it have some special meaning in C language program. In some programs, we use this percentage sign, dollar sign for remainder. Okay, and also we use the some symbols, let's suppose equal sign. So it has some special meanings. This slash have some special meanings, and these curly brackets have some special meanings. Mostly we use these curly brackets for starting of any other condition structure and for ending of any condition structure. Let's suppose if we use the condition structure if, and we use this condition structure 3 times in a single program. So we use these brackets. Okay, we use these brackets for starting the condition structure and for ending the condition structure. And also we use these symbols when we start our main functions. Okay, now I hope you understand now what is the purpose of these symbols in the C language. Okay, now let's move to the next slide, reserved words. Okay, ji. Now, what are the reserved words? In C language, some words have the some special purpose or predefined purpose. So these words are known as the reserved words, or we can also say that these words are the keywords. Okay, in C language we have some words, and these words have this specific purpose and specific meaning in the C language. So these words are known as the keywords. Okay, and they have predefined use and cannot be used for any other purpose. Let's suppose if we write the scanf. So whenever we write scanf in a program, so it have the some specific purpose. We cannot use this scanf for any other purpose. Or we can use the if, as we know that we use this if structure in our unit number 1 when we solve the algorithms. Okay, so in C language this if have a some specific purpose. Okay, if we write the if in any other instructions, so it has that specific purpose. So it means we cannot use the if other than the keywords. Whenever we use if in any step of instructions, let's suppose we use the if in the line number 5, and again we use the if in line number 20, it doesn't matter. If on the line number 5 and if on the line number 20 have the same meanings in the C language program. Okay, so it means the reserved words are cannot be used in the C language program other than their on purpose. There are 32 words defined as the keywords in C language. So what are these keywords in C language? These keywords are, let's suppose, auto, break, case, char, const continue default do. So, but from these 32 keywords, we only used some keywords. Let's suppose normally we use if. In chapter number 1, we use these keywords. If go to. Okay, all of you now understand the go to and if. Okay, because we already learn about the if and go to in the unit number 1. Now, normally we use the float, for loop, okay, and we use the int. And in unit number 1, we also learn about the else. What is the meaning of else? Okay, in unit number 1, we learn about the else, go to, and if. And we know that what they have the meaning. What is the meaning of if? What is the meaning of go to? And what is the meaning of else? Okay, so same in some C language programs, we use the int long, and we also use void. Okay, bas. Next, okay, D. In next slide, we have the header files. Now, what are the header files? Header files contains, C language contains a number of standard functions in library files that perform various tasks in C programs. Now, these tasks includes all the input-output operations and all the math operations. Library file contains the header files, and each header file contains a set of functions. Let's suppose we have a program written in a C language. So normally we write a hash include studio.h, hash include conio.h. So these are the header files, and they have the specific meaning or various tasks in C language program. Okay, and these header files have the some functions. Okay, now in previous lecture we discussed about the linker. So we discussed in previous lecture what is the linker. Linker links the with the library files, okay, and also take the functions from the library files. So now today we discuss about the header files, and we also discuss about the functions. Now let's suppose if we write a header files studio.h, conio.h. okay, so studio.h is the specific meaning. Studio.h means standard input output operation. Okay, this studio.h means standard input output operation. So whenever we write a C language program and we have to take the input from the user, or we have to print something on the screen, so we use this studio.h, because if we don't use this header file, so we cannot use the scanf and printf, because scanf and printf are the functions which are used when we write the header file studio.h. okay, now some commonly used header files are studio.h, conio, and math.com, math.h. Now some commonly used functions that are included in studio file are printf and scanf, etc. And for the conio, we use the getch, clear screen, and the math.h header file contains the mathematical functions such as sqrt, pov, log, sine, cos, and tan. Okay, now from this slide we came to know that in C language program, header files are necessary. First thing. Second thing, whenever we start the program, we start from the header file. Next, if we want to use the functions in a C language program, so we must write the header files of that function in that program. Three things. Okay, first of all, we have to write a header file in the start of program. First thing. Second thing, in C language program, we use different types of functions. And when we use the different types of functions, so according to those functions, we have to write their header files in C language program. Okay, keep it in your mind. These two important things. So let's suppose if we use the scanf or printf, these are two functions in C language program. So whenever we use these two functions, so we have to write the header file of these two functions in C language program. Okay. Now, next. Okay, these are the source program. Okay, source program. In source program, our first step is write the headers. Hash include less than sign, studio dot greater than sign. Okay, now, normally we write the header files with the hash sign. So it means it has a special meaning. Now, studio dot h header files, set of functions that are includes in studio dot h. Means in previous slide, this slide I tell you studio.h contains the scanf, printf, etc. So it means whenever we write here studio.h, so we can use all the functions of studio.h in our program. But if we use the function of studio.h in our program, but we cannot write the studio.h, so our program cannot be executed. Because we use the function of studio.h, but we don't write the studio.h as the header file. Okay, so it means if we write a header file, so we can use the all the functions of that header file. But if we write the functions of that header file and we cannot write the header file, so our programs cannot be executed. Now, structure of a C program. In structure of C program, we have some preprocessor directories. Preprocessor directories means header files. Okay, the header files. Okay. Now, when we write the header files, then we write the main function. Okay, the next is main function. After the main function, we must write the curly bracket. And then we write the some set of instructions. And at the end, we must write the again closing curly bracket. So these step of instructions are known as the body of main function. Body of main functions. Main functions means this main function. And next is user defined function. Function 1, 2, 3, these are the optional. User can write these functions or cannot write these functions. Okay, now, next. For understanding the structure of C language program, let us consider a small and little example. The example is, we have to print a message, I love Pakistan. Okay, so now we have to print I love Pakistan on the computer screen. So how we print the I love Pakistan on the computer screen with the help of C language program. We can write a program hash include studio.h void main void curly bracket printf I love Pakistan closing curly bracket. Now in this C language program, first of all we write the hash include studio.h. These are known as the preprocessor directories. Preprocessor directories. These are known as. Okay. Now, next. Next is void main. So void main is the main function. Void main is the main function, and these printf I love Pakistan, that is the body of main function. Okay, any statement which is written inside the both curly brackets, first curly bracket, second curly bracket, so these statements are known as the body of main function. Okay, now first point, and now discuss the second point. Second point is header files and their functions. Now we have the example. Now we understand with the help of example. Okay, as in this slide, header files, we will discuss about the header files and their functions. Okay, now discuss with the example. Now in this program we have header files, okay, and we also have the their functions. Okay, now what are the meanings of this header file? This is the header file, and their function means printf. Okay, printf, this printf is the function of that header file. Okay, now if we use this printf but we don't use this hash include studio.h, okay, we use the printf but we don't use this studio.h. So it means we write the functions of the studio.h, but we don't write here studio.h. It means our program will be wrong. It cannot be executable. Okay, now because we write the functions of header file studio.h, but we don't write here studio.h. Now, second thing, if we write hash include studio.h as the header file, now we can use all the functions of studio.h. All the functions of studio.h. We write here printf, no, scanf, doesn't matter. It will be executable. So now we came to understand, if we write the header files of studio.h, math.h, conio.h, so then we use the all the functions of that header files. Otherwise, if we write the functions but don't write the header files, so we cannot use these types of functions. Our program will not be executable. I hope now you understand very well. We discussed one example of C language program. Now in next lecture we discuss in detail what are the preprocessor directories, what are the main functions, and what are the main body functions. Okay, now next, if you have the any problem or any question related to today's topic, only today's topic, you can text me